Hello everyone. Just now we had seen the type 4. Now we will see problem based on this type 4. This is one problem that a rigid member PQ is hinged at P and is supported by steel rods A and B. So here steel rod A and this is steel rod B. Diameter of each rod is 10 mm. So diameter of this rod is of 10 mm and a vertical load of 1.4 kN is applied at free end Q. Here we are applying 1.4 kN in downward direction. After loading, the PQ remains same. Means even if we applied the load, this PQ it should not deflect and it should remain same. That is straight and necessarily it should be horizontal. So find the stresses developed in each steel rod. So here we have to find, this is the problem, and we have to find out the stress in rod A and stress in rod B. Now already we had seen, so this is the initial position and the final position. So here we have to take similar triangle principle. So this is the similar triangle. If I take it outside, so this is the similar triangle I will get. So delta L of B divided by this total distance, that should be equal to delta L of A divided by this distance. So I will get equation by applying similar triangle principle, delta L of B divided by 2 equal to delta L of A divided by A. So if I rearrange this, then I will get delta L of B, if I multiply this, then twice delta L of A. Now we'll elaborate this. Delta L is equal to PL upon A, that I will put in this equation. So I will get PL upon AE of the rod B, where P is the load acting on rod B, L is length of this rod B, and A is the cross section area of this rod B, and E is the Young's modulus of this rod B. And that should be equal to twice, similarly, load acting on rod A, length of A, area of rod A and Young's modulus of rod A. As area and Young's modulus is same for both material. So as they have already mentioned, the each rod is having 10 mm diameter. So the cross sectional area of the rod A, it becomes cross sectional area of the rod B. And both are having same material. So Young's modulus, again it is same. So this area it will get cancelled, Young's modulus and Young's modulus it will get cancelled. So now if I put the value of length of B and length of A, I will get one relation. So P, B as it is, length of this B, that is 1 meter they have given, that I converted into the mm, 1000, that is equal to twice P A as it is into length of the rod A, 0.8 meter, so therefore 800. Now if I rearrange this, then I will get, if I take 1000 here, then PB equal to 1.6 into load of APA. So this I will get the equation 1. So we got one equation, but these are the two unknown which is not possible to solve the PB and PA value. So another one condition I have to see. So now the force diagram. So this is the force diagram. Now I will take moment about this point. Three forces, this PA, PB and this 1.4, and this PA into 1000, that is minus PB into 2000 plus 1.4 into 10 to the 3 into this 3000. So the all forces that I am taking in Newton and the distance in mm. So now if I take moment about this point, then I will get, so here the distance they kept as it is in meter, so PA into 1, as this is anti-clockwise moment, so that's why I am taking it as a negative. Then PB into this distance 2, and again it is anti-clockwise, so therefore it is minus, and then it is 1400, that is in Newton, into this distance 3, and as this is rotating in clockwise, so therefore it is positive. So if I rearrange this, then I will get PA plus twice PB, that should be equal to 4200. So this is the equation number 2. Now see, from equation number 1 and from equation number 2. both the equation contains PB and PA, PB and PA. Now what I will do, the value of PB from equation 1 I will put in equation number 2. So from equation 1 and 2 we will get PA plus twice into PB value I will take from this equation number 1. What it is? 1.6 into PA. So that is equal to 4200. Now the only unknown is PA. So from this I will get value of the PA, that is load acting on rod A. So that is of 1000. Once I get load acting on this rod, I will put in the equation number 1. Then I will get load acting on rod B. So that is 1600. Now what we have to find out at the end, the stress induced in it. So now already we calculated the load acting on rod A and load acting on rod B. So now we can easily find out, because the diameter they had given, area you can calculate. So this is the circular, so pi by 4 d square, that is pi by 4 10 square, you will get the area. So therefore stress in rod A is equal to stress in rod A equal to load acting on rod A divided by cross section area of A. So the load 1000 and area, that is pi by 4 10 square of this A, will get 78.5398. so you will get the stress in the rod A 12.732 newton per mm square. Similarly, stress in the rod B also you can find out. Similar way, stress in B equal to load acting on rod B divided by cross sectional area of rod B. So the load on B is 1600 and the cross sectional area is same. So if we put, then we can calculate the stress acting in the rod B, that is 20.3718 newton per mm square. In this way, we can find out the stresses in each rod. Thank you.